Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem on counter flow heat exchanger. So let's get started. Here is the question on the counter flow heat exchanger. The problem is given. Now whatever is given in the problem, I'll write that in the form of data. First, it is given water mass is 1.4 kg per second. Is the mass flow rate of water. Then Cp, the specific heat of water, is given 4.187. Kilojoule per kg Kelvin is heated from 40 degree Celsius to 70 degree Celsius. It means water would be the cold fluid because it is heated. So initially having the less temperature 40, so that would be TCI, the inlet temperature of water, which is the cold fluid, 40 degree Celsius, and the exit temperature is 70, so that is TCO for water. Since water is being heated, so that becomes the cold fluid. I'll mention it over here. And since this is the cold fluid, mass flow rate of water would be denoted by m dot c, and specific heat would be cpc. Then it is heated by an oil. So the next fluid is oil having mass flow rate 2 kg per second. So obviously it would be, since water is the cold fluid and we are having the heat exchanger, so the hot fluid would be oil, which is given. Mass flow rate of oil is 2 kg per second, so that becomes the mass flow rate of the hot fluid. Specific heat of oil, it is given 1.9 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So that would be CpH, specific heat of hot fluid. Then entering at 110 degree Celsius in a counter flow heat exchanger. So entering temperature is given, it means it is THI. And the type of heat exchanger is mentioned, so I'll write it into the question that the type of heat exchanger here is counter flow heat exchanger. Then if the overall heat transfer coefficient is 350 watt per meter square Kelvin, calculate the surface area required. Overall heat transfer coefficient is denoted by capital U, 350 watt per meter square Kelvin. We have to find out the surface area for this counter flow heat exchanger. So with the data understood, let us get started with the solution part. In the solution, first I'll draw the diagram for the counter flow heat exchanger. Here, since we are having a counter flow heat exchanger, hot fluid flows in this tube from left towards right, whereas cold fluid enters from the opposite end, that is from right towards left. Since the directions are opposite, that is why it is called as the counter flow heat exchanger. Now just below this, I'll draw the temperature distribution diagram or the temperature variation for a counter flow heat exchanger. Y-axis would indicate the temperature, x-axis indicates the length of the heat exchanger. Hot fluid is entering from left side, its temperature is THI at inlet. It goes on reducing continuously along the length of the heat exchanger and becomes THO at exit. Then cold fluid enters from the right side at a temperature of TCI, continuously gains the heat and becomes TCO at exit. The temperature difference on the left hand side is denoted as delta T1. On the right hand side it is delta T2. So here also we can see the hot fluid direction and the cold fluid direction are opposite. Hot fluid continuously loses the heat, whereas the cold fluid is gaining the heat. Next, I'll write the formula of heat transfer, that since the total rate of heat transfer is given by, for a heat exchanger, it can be either parallel flow or counter flow. The heat transfer formula remains same, which is Q is equal to UA LMTD, because we are using the LMTD method. And why we are using LMTD method? The reason for it being, I'll keep it as equation 1. The reason is, out of these 4 temperatures, 3 temperatures are known to us. So when we have such a condition, we can use LMTD method. Otherwise, if only 2 temperatures are given, that mostly the inlet temperatures, then we have to use the ENTU method. So now this can be easily solved by using the LMTD method. This I have given as equation 1. Now to calculate the surface area, we require LMTD and total rate of heat transfer. First I'll go for the total rate of heat transfer. Like, therefore, heat lost by hot fluid is equal to the heat gained by cold fluid. So therefore the heat, capital Q, is lost by hot fluid is m dot h cph into the temperature difference for hot fluid, thi minus tho. Now that is equal to m dot c, mass flow rate of cold fluid, specific heat of cold fluid, into temperature change, tco minus tci for the cold fluid. Now when we look at this equation, there are two things which we can find from here. First, Q would be calculated, because THI and THO, from that we only know the value of THI. THO is not given, that we have to find out. But when we see TCO and TCI, these values are given. So first I'll get the value of capital Q, and then I'll go for THO from the same equation. So therefore Q is equal to m dot c, it is for the cold fluid given in the problem as 1.4. Specific heat is 4.187 for water, which is the cold fluid here. The temperature difference, TCO minus TCI, 70 minus 40. So from this I'll get the total rate of heat transfer and Q value. It comes out to be, it is 175.85. and now since this CP value is in terms of kilojoule, so the final answer of heat transfer would be in the form of kilowatts. And why it is so? Because the mass flow rate 1.4 is in terms of kg per second, specific heat is kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and the temperature difference, either we can take it in Kelvin or degree Celsius, the difference remains same, so I am keeping it as Kelvin. So K gets cancelled, kg and kg gets cancelled, kilojoule per second remains, and this kilojoule per second is kilowatts. So the final unit is kilowatts. Now converting it into watts, that is 175.85 into 10 raised to 3 watts. So that is the value of Q. Now using the same equation, I'll get THO, that is m dot h cph into thi minus tho. Q value is 175.85. now when I'm keeping Q in terms of kilowatts, CP value should be in terms of kilojoule. That point we have to remember, otherwise if we are keeping CP in terms of joule, we have to write down watts here. So m dot h is given, that is 2, specific heat of oil is 1.9, and here the temperature difference, it is THI is 110. So on calculating this, I'll get the answer of THO and it comes out to be 63.72 degrees Celsius. Now once all the four temperatures are known, we can go for delta T1 and delta T2. Once these values are known, we can find the LMTD. So delta T1 is THI minus TCO. THI is 110, TCO was given as 70, delta T1 is 40 degrees Celsius, similarly delta T2 would be THO minus TCI, THO value is 63.72, TCI is 40. So therefore delta T2 is 23.72 degrees Celsius. Now once delta T1 and delta T2 are known, we can go for LMTD for counter flow. I'll write the formula. LMTD is given by delta T1 minus delta T2 upon ln of delta T1 divided by delta T2. Delta T1 is 40 and T2 is 23.72. So from this, I am getting the answer of LMTD as 31.15 degrees Celsius. Now after getting the LMTD value, we can put all values in equation number 1 to get the surface area because heat transfer is also known. So therefore left hand side is Q and Q came out to be 175.85 into 10 raised to 3 watts. Now why I am keeping Q in terms of watts, the reason being that this overall heat transfer coefficient is given as 350 watt per meter square Kelvin. So if U is in terms of watts, even the left hand side, that is Q value, should be in terms of watts, that is 350 into the surface area into LMTD, which is 31.15. So on calculating this, the total area comes out to be 16.13 meter square. So that's the answer. So when we see this problem, the question was to get the surface area of the heat exchanger. We have calculated it. It came out to be 16.13 meter square. And with this, the problem gets completed. In the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you can like, share, comment, and subscribe our channel. And share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.